Ciao a tutti, we are at day 22 of our wine quarantine. Today I'm going to take you to a different part of Italy, and here in Boston anyway, it's a beautiful sunny day, so I wanted to celebrate spring with this white wine I'm going to be talking about today. So, if you take a plane and we flew into Milan, from Milan we'll be heading eastwards, right at the base of Lake Garda. So maybe you already guessed, we're talking today about Turbiana. Turbiana is the gorgeous white grape used for the production of the wine known as Lugana DOC. Maybe not the most popular of grapes, but definitely a grape that's been around for quite a bit of time. Figure has been around since the 17th century, at least those were the first mentions. And for a very long time, Turbiana was thought to be exactly the same as both Trebbiano di Soave from the Soave area, as well as the Verdicchio from the very important Verdicchio from the Marche. Although more current studies and research tell us that actually Turbiana is not the same as Verdicchio and Trebbiano di Soave, but there are similarities. Now, what makes the major difference of these wines is where we are. We are right in between the regions of Veneto and Lombardy, and there is Lago di Garda. Lago di Garda is one of the many glacial lake located in northern Italy, such as Lago di Seo, Lago di Como, Lago Maggiore, and whatnot. So what happened was, you know, the glaciers advanced a million years ago, and eventually as the glaciers retreated, they left behind all this rocks in the soils that give great minerality to the wines, but also left us behind all the lakes. Being Lake Garda, such a big lake, creates this beautiful Mediterranean condition. So conditions are mild, allows for the beautiful ripening of the fruit onto the vines. And as a matter of fact, one of the uniqueness of this particular part of Italy is that also around Lake Garda, you're going to find both olive groves as well as citrus trees. Now, the Lugana DOC, which is the appellation we're referring to, it's a fairly small appellation that is broken down almost like in two parts, because part of it's in Lombardy, part of it's in Veneto. And also, soils-wise, the vineyards or the soils that are closer to the lake in the townships of Desenzano, Sirmione, Peschiera del Garda, they're more clay-based, again, with this topsoil of morainic origin, plenty of rocks. As you move a little bit further away from the lake shores, we find a slightly higher elevation. We're still talking about only about 350 feet, so fairly low. And here the soils are more clay with a good amount of sand, so the wines tend to be maybe less mineral, a bit richer on the palate and whatnot. So the wine we're tasting today, by the way, it's by Gerardo Cesari. It's called Lugana DOC 100 Filari. 100 Filari implies that the wine is made only with 100 rows of vines, so small production wine. So this is the color. It's a fairly golden color. When you look on the smell on the nose, the wine has got this beautiful Meyer lemon quality, but also is a melon, a little bit of pineapple, beautiful almond, and definitely this very, very clean mineral quality on the nose. Let's take a sip. The palate, brilliant acidity, very, very crisp. But then, you know, the acidity carries on the wine and the wine for a while on the palate. Gives great freshness, nice intensity of the flavor, and also almost like a flinty quality that really keeps it very, very pleasant. Again, this is 2016, so we're in 2020, so also tells you that Lugana has got fantastic aging potential when made with quality in mind, right? That's all for today. In alto e cuori, until tomorrow. Ciao!